Hello learners, welcome you all in this video. Myself Yogesh Subhash Bhavsar. I completed my bachelor's degree and master's degree in electrical engineering and currently I'm working as an assistant professor in electrical engineering for MVPs, KBT College of Engineering, Nashik. So here I'm starting the series of videos based on basic electrical engineering. So stay tuned for this channel. So here in first video we'll learn the fundamental concepts related to basic electrical engineering like electromotive force, potential difference, electric current, electrical resistance and Ohm's law. So let us see these concepts one by one. These all concepts you should know before going to study details about the various concepts of basic electrical engineering. So now let us see first, that is electromotive force. We often use this term for defining the voltage of battery or the fuel cells. We can say the EMF of battery or the EMF of cell. So what exactly the electromotive force is? See, it is an electrical force or pressure that causes electrons to flow in a particular direction. So what? It is an electrical force or pressure that causes the electrons to flow in a particular direction. We know that the electricity can conduct through the conductors. The metals are having good conductivity and insulators are having bad conductivity. So here the EMF, as soon as we apply EMF to this conductor, there will be flow of electrons. So this is what, due to this electromotive force, the electron will be flowing inside the metal or the conductor. This EMF is denoted by E or V and it is measured in volts, right? So here in this diagram we can see there is a source of EMF. It may be either battery or the fuel cells. So there is a positive terminal and the negative terminal. We know that the electrons flow from the negative to positive terminals and the current we can denote from positive to negative. So this EMF, electromotive force, will cause the electrons to flow. That means it will causes the current to flow in this circuit. And as we connect the circuit to this EMF source, the light or the bulb we are connected here, which will glow. All metals contain number of free electrons, which moves randomly inside metal. And when the EMF is applied to this metal, these free electrons moves in a particular direction. So this is what, you know, the structure of atom. There is a nucleus and free electrons in the outermost orbits. So these free electrons causes the electrons to flow, right? There will be a number of free electrons in the outermost orbit. If the number of electrons are more, then their conductivity is good. So here again, in this GIF image, we can see there is a source of EMF, there is a bulb, and this is the switch. So whenever the switch is connected, the switch, the circuit will be closed and it causes electrons to flow, right? This is the negative side and this is the positive side. So it is connected it here. Electrons are flowing from negative towards the positive. As soon as we close this switch, the bulb is glowing. So this is what the electromotive force, which causes the electrons to flow. Then what is potential difference? PD. Here we can see there are two points. One is a positive point, another is the negative. The potential difference, simply the difference between the potential of two charge points, right? So this is called the potential difference. Simply it is the difference between the potential at two points. It is denoted by V and measured in volts. It is similar to the EMF. Potential difference is the work done in moving a unit of positive electric charge from one point to another point. So often we call the voltage as a potential difference between two points. At any point we can measure the potential difference. If there is no potential difference, then we can say there will be no voltage. Now one question often comes in mind. So what is the difference between the EMF and the potential difference? Okay. So here we can see in this circuit, as I said, the EMF is for the source. So here the battery is connected and we can say the EMF of battery, right? And this battery will cause the electrons to flow in the circuit. There is a resistance at point A and B, and we can measure the potential difference or the voltage across this point A and B. That means across the resistance. So this is what the EMF at the source, and the potential difference we can measure at any two point, between any two points, right? So at that point we can measure the potential difference, and the source which causes the electrons to flow, it is called the EMF. So this is what the difference, basic difference between the EMF and the potential difference. And one thing is that the potential difference is always less than the EMF, because there will be a resistance of the conductor due to which the voltage may drop. The next thing is electric current. As I said, the electromotive force which causes the electrons to flow in a particular direction. So current is nothing but the rate of flow of electrons, or we can say rate of flow of charged particle. Generally it is called electrons. So here we can see, if this EMF is connected to the resistor, then it causes the electrons to flow. That means it causes the current to flow. So conventional current, we can often define the direction of current with the help of conventional current flow. So this is from positive to negative. And the electron current, we know the electrons will move from negative to positive, right? The current is always denoted by I and measured in amperes. The equation of current is given by I is equal to Q by T, where Q is the charge in coulombs and T is the time in second, right? So here again we can see one EMF source which is connected to the bulb, and from positive to negative there is a direction of current we often denote, and this is called the conventional current flow. And the direction of electrons flow, which is from negative to positive, we can say it is an electron current. So this is what the electric current, which is due to the EMF. The next concept is electrical resistance. The electrical resistance, it is nothing but the opposition offered by the conductor to the flow of electric current. Right? Here is the symbol of electrical resistance, and in often various circuits we have seen this type of element, which is called the resistor, which opposes the current to flow in the conductor. It is denoted by R, capital R, and measured in ohm from the scientist who discovered it, George Ohm, who named it as a ohm. So conductors are like copper, aluminium, offers low resistance, and insulators like wood, plastic offers high resistance. As I said in the first slide, that conductors like various metals will have free electrons in the valence shell so that current can flow easily. Resistance can be calculated by capital R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of material, L be the length of the material, length of the conductor, and A be the cross-sectional area of the conductor. The resistivity is nothing but the resistance of a meter of conductor. That means for 1 meter, what is the resistance? It is called the resistivity. So this is called electrical resistance. And the last thing is that the Ohm's law. This is very useful law for the electrical engineering. In various circuit, this law plays an important role while calculating the unknown voltage, current or resistance in the circuit. So here we can see the statement of Ohm's law. It is stated that the current through a conductor between two points is directly proportional to the voltage across two points, with all physical conditions are kept constant. That means what? The current through the conductor. Let's say there is a conductor whose resistance is R. Voltage V is applied to that conductor, so it causes current I to flow. So for this conductor, let's say this I, which is a current across these two points, which is proportional to the voltage across it. Right? This is from the Ohm's law statement. Mathematically, it can be written, current is proportional to the voltage. And V is equal to IR. If we want to neglect the proportionality, then we have to insert a constant. And according to Ohm, this R is the constant of proportionality known as the resistance of the conductor. So here we can see in this circuit, the conductor is here, it is represented by a resistance R. The current flowing is I, the voltage applied is V across the conductor. So this is what the various basic concepts related to the electrical engineering. So you often know these concepts. So before going to study details about the content. So here are the references we referred for making this presentation. So hope you understood all the concepts. So thank you for watching this video. Thank you.